Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on lever loaded safety valve. For that purpose, here we have a question. The question is quite lengthy. I'll read it so that we can understand that what is given in this part. Now, a lever loaded safety valve is 70 mm in diameter and is to be designed for a boiler to blow off at a pressure of 1 Newton per mm square gauge. Design a suitable mild steel lever for rectangular cross section using following permissible stresses: tensile stress 70 MPa, shear stress 50 MPa, bearing pressure 25 Newton per mm square. The distance from fulcrum to the weight of the lever is 880 mm and the distance between fulcrum and load is 80 mm. Now this is the question which we have. Here we need to design the lever loaded safety valve. I'll quickly draw the diagram and explain what is a lever loaded safety valve. Here I'm drawing a lever loaded safety valve. Now, this is an opening. In this opening, we are having a valve. Now, what happens is that this valve is used in case of boilers where the steam pressure is very high. So steam, it would be coming from the bottom, that is from the boiler. Here this steam enters and then it will try to lift this valve. Next, this valve has some pin attached to it. Next, after this, this portion is extended. Now, this is the diagram of a lever loaded safety valve. When steam pressure comes, it will try to lift this valve, and this valve is kept in its position by this value of P, which is called as the effort. Now, here we have this end, this is called as the fulcrum end, where the steam pressure acts, this is called as the load end. Now, these are the pins which we need to design, and this is the lever cross section. Here we have this as the lever which we would be designing. So this is a lever loaded safety valve. Now for simplification, I'll draw another diagram which we would be using in the problem. Now, I'll read the question. A lever loaded safety valve is 70 mm in diameter. So the diameter of this valve is equal to the diameter of this portion. This is, I'll denote it by capital D. So this capital D is given to us. It is equal to 70 mm. Next, and it is to be designed for a boiler to blow off at a pressure of 1 Newton per mm square gauge. So the pressure inside this boiler, this is P, this is the pressure of steam here, so that P is equal to 1 Newton per millimeter square. Next, design a suitable mild steel lever for rectangular cross section. The cross section of the lever is rectangular, they have given, using following permissible stresses. Here I'll write the values. Tensile stress sigma t is equal to 70 Newton per mm square. Next, shear stress tau 50 Newton per mm square. Bearing pressure P suffix B is equal to 25 Newton per mm square. Next, they have given some distances. The distance from fulcrum to the weight of the lever is 880 mm. So here the weight of the lever is nothing but the effort which we are applying. This is called as the weight of the lever. So distance between fulcrum. Now fulcrum is at this end. So here this is the fulcrum. I'll take the center of this. So from the fulcrum to the point where the load is acting, this is 880 mm. Next, and the other distance is also given in the problem. That is, and the distance between fulcrum and load is 80 mm. So load is acting at this pin, which is second, as we can see. So this is the load pin, and at this its center, the distance between fulcrum and the load, that is given as 80 millimeters. Now I'll denote here, this is the fulcrum end, fulcrum, here there is load. Fulcrum I'll denote it by F, load is denoted by W. As it is very much clear from the diagram that load is acting from downwards, so the load on this pin, it is from downward direction, that is W. Effort is downward. Now I need to calculate how much is the load which is acting. So for the solution of this, whatever we have written here, that is a part of the data. So it is given data. Next, we need to design this entire lever with the pins and even the lever cross section. So in this solution part, I'll say that since weight acting on the valve, that will be given by weight is equal to area pi by 4 d square multiplied by the internal pressure. So now from this I'll say that therefore W is equal to pi by 4, diameter is 70 square into pressure is 1. So from this I'll get the value of W, and that comes out to be 3850 newton. Now this much is the load which is acting from the downward direction. Now after getting W, I can say that therefore reaction at the fulcrum, that we can calculate RF is equal to, now that reaction, it can be calculated once we have W and P values. W value we already have, we have calculated just now. P we don't have. So reaction at fulcrum, I'll say that that will be equal to either it is load minus effort, or it can be effort minus load, depending on the value. I'll keep this as on equation number 1. Now we will go to find P. For that purpose, I'll say that therefore taking moments of all forces at the fulcrum. Now that moment we can calculate by, I can say that since we want to calculate moment at the fulcrum, here I'll consider clockwise moment as positive. So it is P into 880, because the distance from fulcrum to this load is 880 mm. So therefore P into 880. Next, effort is acting downward, load is acting upward. So here the moment produced by load, that is anticlockwise. So it is minus W into 80 mm. That is equal to 0. From this, P will be equal to, I'll shift this term onto the other side, W into 80 divided by 880. Now W we have calculated, it was 3850. So therefore the value of P, it comes out to be 350 newton. Now once I have P value and even W, I'll say that
therefore put W and P in equation number 1. So here I have RF is equal to, it was W minus P in equation 1, W was 3850 minus P is 350. So from this I will get my value of RF as 3500 newton. Now once I know the reaction at the fulcrum, I know the value which is coming here, that is the force. Now because of this reaction, what will happen, that since it is a force, the fulcrum pin is acted upon by this force, and then there would be some kind of failure of this fulcrum pin. So I'll say that after reaching this stage, now I'll say that therefore we are designing, first step number one, we will design fulcrum pin. Now when we are considering fulcrum pin, fulcrum pin would be there inside a bush. Now this is fulcrum pin, here we have bush, the length of bush is taken approximately equal to the length of the fulcrum pin, and since pin is, it is made up of metal, even the bush is made up of metal, so because of metal to metal rubbing, the phenomenon is called as bearing, because this pin would be rotating inside the bush, and the area which gets worn out, that I can draw it, that is if this is a pin, then this is called as bearing area, diameter of fulcrum pin. Now I'll say that therefore the area which I draw this, it would be projected area. This is diameter of fulcrum pin, and here I have length of fulcrum pin. So therefore, considering bearing failure of fulcrum pin. Now when we are considering the bearing failure, I'll say that therefore bearing strength, it will be given by, since we want strength and strength is nothing but the load carrying capacity at the fulcrum, the load is nothing but reaction at fulcrum, and that will be equal to bearing pressure multiplied by the resisting area. Now therefore reaction at the fulcrum, that value we have, it is 3500, bearing pressure is given in the problem as 25, bearing area is df into lf. Here I'll say that let lf be 1.25 times of df, this relation I'm assuming called as empirical relation, so length of fulcrum pin be 1.25 times of diameter of fulcrum pin. So from this, if I calculate, go on calculating this, then at the fulcrum, we know that the load which is acting, that is 3500, and from this we would be getting the value as DF, it comes out to be, it is close to, we can say 10 mm, so it is, I am taking the value as 12. So this is the diameter of fulcrum pin. After this I can say that therefore LF, length of fulcrum pin, is 1.25 into diameter of fulcrum pin, which is 12. From this I'll get LF value as 15 mm. Now as we can see here, Your reaction at fulcrum, this value was 3500 Newton. Load is 3850. So there is not much difference here. So whatever dimensions we are keeping at the fulcrum end, same would be there at the load end. So after this, I'll say that therefore, taking same dimensions for load pin. So now I'll say that therefore, load pin diameter, I'll take it as D1, and that will be equal to the fulcrum pin diameter, which is 12 mm. Length of load pin, I'll take it as L1. Its value is same as the length of fulcrum pin. I'll say that let D1 is equal to diameter of load pin, L1 is equal to length of load pin. Now after getting this, I can say that in your step number one, I have designed the fulcrum pin and even the load pin. Next, after this, what we can do is checking fulcrum pin, or we can say now even the load pin. So it is fulcrum pin under shear. Now here we are checking the fulcrum pin under shear. When it's shear, it will break into three parts like this, which is called as double shear. So I'll say that if DF is the diameter of the fulcrum pin, then therefore resisting area, it will be pi by 4 into diameter of fulcrum pin square into 2, because it is a case of double shear. Now after getting this resisting area, I'll say that therefore shearing strength of fulcrum pin, since we are finding strength, strength is the load, load at the fulcrum is RF, and we want to know the shearing strength. So that is shear stress into area. So therefore RF is 3500. Shear stress is what we want to check. Area is pi by 4 into DF, which is 12 square multiplied by 2. So from this I will get shear stress value as 15.47 Newton per millimeter square. Now this value of shear stress is less than the given value. In the question, shear stress is given as 50 and we are getting it as 15.47. So this value is less than tau, which is permissible, that is the given value, which is 50. So I'll say that therefore fulcrum pin is safe under shear. Now in this step number one, we have designed both fulcrum pin and load pin. Next, I'll say that we will design the lever cross section. So step number two, it is design of lever cross section. Now for the lever cross section design, I'll draw a simple diagram. I'm just taking this section, that is a part of this lever. Now lever looks something like this. Now this extended portion, this is called as boss. And here we have internal hole, and inside this we are inserting the pin. So first I'll say that for the lever cross section, when I'm designing, I'll say that since diameter of pin is at both the ends, that is, this is the fulcrum, which is F, and this is the load end. So at F and W we have designed the pin, so the diameter of pin is equal to, we have got the value as 12 mm. Now this pin is inserted in a bush, and after the bush it is inserted in this lever section. So here we need to calculate how much is the hole in this lever. So for that I'll say that, therefore, assuming 2 mm thickness of bush, so therefore the diameter of hole in the lever, the diameter of hole inside this lever, it will be the diameter of pin, which is 12, plus, since I am using 2 mm thickness of bush, so therefore this diameter of hole in the lever, I'll denote it by D suffix H. So therefore this value will be 16 mm. It means inside this lever section we have to make a drill of 16 mm. Now this external portion is called as boss, so I'll say that, therefore, diameter of boss, it is equal to 2 into diameter of hole, that is 16. So diameter of boss comes out to be, I'll denote it as capital D, it comes out to be 32 mm. Now as it is given in the problem that the cross section of the lever is rectangle, so I'll say that, therefore, for rectangular cross section of the lever, I'll say that this is the cross section, here this is the thickness, and here I have width of the lever cross section. I'll say that let the relation be B is equal to 4 times of T, this I am assuming. Now when I am considering lever cross section, I will design this lever very close to this fulcrum section, that is here, I'll take a section here that is close to the load section. So now here the area which is there, which is the cross section area, it is a rectangular in section. So this rectangular section we have to design, and effort is acting. So here I need to know all the distances. So I'll say that taking moments close to this section, which I'll call it as section YY. So I'll say that after this, therefore, taking moments at section YY. Now when I'm taking the moment, that will be equal to P is the effort multiplied by this distance, and this distance I can take it as 880 minus 80. From this I will subtract the radius of the hole. So I'll say that, therefore, this M is equal to P into, the distance is 880 minus 80. From that I will subtract the radius of hole. Diameter of hole is 16, radius of hole is divided by 2. So here I'm taking the moment at this section. 880 minus 80 minus the radius of this hole will give me this distance. So now I'll put the values. P is given, that was 350. Next, this is 800 minus 8. So finally M comes out to be, it is 277 200 newton mm. So this is the value of bending moment which I am getting. After this, I'll say that therefore section modulus z, it will be equal to tb square by 6. For rectangular section, this is the section modulus. Now therefore I'll say that bending stress is equal to m upon z. So finally, bending stress, if I look into this problem, bending stress is not given in the data, but we can take tensile stress equal to bending stress because both are principal stresses. Now sigma b is 70, m it was 277200, z it was tb square by 6. So here I have 70 is equal to 6 will go into the numerator, t here b I can say that it is equal to 40 because I have assumed since b is equal to 40. So therefore from this here I will get this value as this becomes t cube. I will shift it onto the other side. So t cube is equal to the numerator 277200 into 6 divided by this 70 will come here, 4 square into 16, that is. So finally I'll get the cube root of t and that is 11.4 or we can say 12 mm. Now once we have got the thickness, I'll say that even width can be calculated. So therefore b is equal to 4t, so it is 4 into 12, so b comes out to be 48 mm. Now this is the lever cross section, that is as we have this lever here, the thickness of the lever which we have found out, that thickness is 12 mm and this width of the lever, that is equal to 48 mm. So we have designed this lever cross section, we have designed both the fulcrum pin and the load pin. So in this video we have seen how to design the lever loaded safety valve by considering the pressure of steam, converting that into load, and then designing fulcrum pin, load pin, and finally the lever cross section. I hope whatever is explained here, that is understood.